Well, guys, the wondering is over. Joe Douglas has filled his first hole, taken his first risk. Well, he signed up a backup player. But hey, it's pretty cool. Let's talk about it. Hey, guys, welcome back to JetsHQ. I'm Howie. It's great to have you back. Hey, putting out a video within the last, 48 hours of my last video. Much faster. We're back on track now, so things are starting to happen. And it's good to see. We were spitballing a little bit before in the last video about how we were going to fill the hole that's being left by Chris Herndon's four-game suspension. And we were kind of spitballing about how Joe Douglas would attack it. And he answered that question for us pretty quickly. So he's moving pretty quick. And we signed tight end Ryan Griffin from formerly from the Texans, and it's not the most stellar signing, but there really can't be a stellar signing here. There's just nobody available to fill that spot. But this is a good depth move, and we'll talk a little bit about Ryan Griffin. The Jets also made a couple of personnel moves later in the day. We'll talk about those also. It's really nothing big, but it's something to talk about. So just before the Jets are getting ready to step foot into camp. We got tight end Ryan Griffin. Now, Ryan Griffin has been in the league for 6 years. He came into the league in the 2013 draft, and he was a sixth-round pick by the Houston Texans, number 201 overall, out of the University of Connecticut. Now, University of Connecticut, he was a really good player. He actually, in 2012, was voted the UConn's Player of the Year. So, the guy has some talent. He's actually a two-way tight end, which what that means is that he can both catch and run routes, and he can also block. So he's very versatile. He's never really put up huge numbers, but he does have the ability to act and perform certain things within the scheme of a receiving tight end as well as a blocking tight end. So the Jets can use him to fill in for those four games and not have to keep switching out personnel and tipping off their plays. So it's valuable signing. Now the Houston Texans cut Ryan Griffin in April. So we'll talk about why that happened. But just to give you the scoop on Ryan Griffin, he's 6'6", 255 pounds, and he's 29 years old. His total seasons totals for 6 years with the Texans, he played in 77 games. He started 36 of them. He had 136 receptions, 1,491 yards, and a total of 7 touchdowns. Last year, he started 11 games. He played 14, but started 11 games for the Texans and was their starting tight end. Before that, he had played behind guys like Owen Daniels and C.J. Fedorowicz over in Houston. So he was a backup for first 5 or 6 years, and then he just got on the field as a starter this last year. Texans held on to him for quite a while. They found him pretty valuable, and he ended up signing a $3 million deal late with the Texans, which is probably one of the reasons they ended up cutting him. Now, he had been released, and the reason that the Houston Texans gave for his release was that he had gotten into some kind of a scrum out of the hotel room. He broke a window. He was intoxicated. He was arrested for public intoxication and vandalism. And those charges were eventually dropped, but the Texans kind of used that story as a means to release Mr. Griffin. But really, it sure looked like a cap move. They saved about $2.7 million on the cap with the cut, and they have a bunch of young tight ends that they're developing over there. And I guess Mr. Griffin was starting to get a little aged for them, and he had never really taken over the starting role, or he didn't develop in that last year the way they had hoped that he would. Last year he didn't score any touchdowns at all. He had 24 receptions, 305 yards. So not much production in the starting role. Now, what does that mean for the Jets? Well, it means that the Jets aren't expecting him to be Gronkowski, but they are expecting him to fill in the role and to merge together with Wesco and Tomlinson that the Jets have to kind of create a trio with the ability to cover and block and also receive. But, it's only for the four games. I'm quite certain that Chris Herndon's position will be safe when he comes back from his 4-game suspension. So it's a good move. It's not that risky. It's better than the aged veterans that probably or very likely would get hurt within their first 4 games. So it's not a bad move. And besides, if he plays fairly well, he can hang on for depth behind Herndon and kind of seal up that position so that we can look elsewhere. And it wasn't a very expensive move. So, you know, all in all, looking pretty good. Okay, so aside from the signing of Griffin, the Jets made 3 player personnel moves yesterday. And the first one was Marcus Maye. Now, Marcus Maye, starting to show a little bit of an injury history, but, you know, he's a very important safety, a very good player. He could be a top safety in the league, so we're concerned. I think the Jets are playing this a little bit carefully. They put him on the PUP list, so it's the physically unable to perform list, so that he's not going to be practicing with the team, but he also doesn't take up a roster spot during that time, and the Jets can practice and see people around him. He gets a chance to rehab unencumbered, and then he'll come back and play. He's obviously going to be able to start the first game of the season, and the Jets are protecting that with this move, so it's a good move. They also put Brandon Bryant, one of our defensive backs, on the PUP list. He has an undisclosed injury, and he was on the practice squad last year. Looks like he'll be able to come back later in camp and join the team and practice then too. So he may preserve his spot on the practice squad, or he may show us something, but he's cutting his time down to really perform and try to win a position. But the Jets aren't ready to give up on him yet, so they're protecting him. They put him on the PUP list as well. And then also Blisson Austin, as expected, he's on the non-football injury list, although I find it hard to believe that this is a non-football injury. He blew out his ACL twice in Rutgers playing football, but it didn't happen in the NFL, so I guess they're going to consider this a non-football injury list. Honestly, it seems to me that Joe Douglas is trying to protect a little bit of Mike Maccagnan's reputation here by not releasing his 6th-round pick before camp even starts. So he's going to give Blisson Austin a chance to rehab and maybe rejoin the team on the sidelines if he can stand up straight. It is a shame that, you know, Blisson Austin, I'm sure, is a wonderfully talented person, but with his knees in the condition they are, it's hard to expect him to make the team in any way, take up any spot from somebody who's physically able to play. So we'll just have to see and watch. The Jets obviously are still holding out some hope for that one. So we'll take a look. We'll see how that turns out. So that's it for today. Thank you guys for tuning back in. I'm sure we'll have many, many, many more updates. Camp hasn't even started yet. We're already updating the board. The next time you see me, we'll probably have the board in the background, and I'll have all my my updates on there. We'll get it up to speed and probably have about 90 people on it to whittle down. Also, I want to thank you guys for all the support. It's really been amazing. Also, if you guys want to send in some pictures, I don't have any pictures to display for this particular video. We just had the last video, so it didn't give anybody much time. But please feel free to send in your pictures if you want to get them on the videos. The link will be in the description below for you to send them to me, so I really appreciate that. Love all of the sharing and the support. Also, if you want to support the channel, you can feel free to do that as well. There'll be a link in the description below to do that, and I really appreciate all the help that you guys feel like giving, so it really is appreciated. And I want to thank you guys very much. We'll be doing a video here real soon, and you guys have a great one. We'll see you when camp starts. Let's go Jets! I wish on stupid YouTube there was a way you could get people to join a group or follow along with you, or hey Noah, Sam, is there a way on YouTube you can have people follow you or join your group or something?
What do you mean subscribe?
Yeah, what's that?
Subscribing. It's the little red button right here, and once they do that, they're subscribed to your channel.
Okay, so what if you want them to get like a message that you just put a video out or something like that?
Dad, you're a dummy. All they have to do is click the bell icon right there to receive notifications that JetsHQ posted a video.
Mother...